for my first video on thermodynamics. I am back with a new video on thermodynamics second. In this video, we will study the thermodynamic system, surrounding, boundary and different type of thermodynamic system and thermodynamic process. So, let us start. Then, what is the thermodynamic system? For that, consider a 12th science class, and in this class the number of students are present, means this class is collection or group of objects. It for a 12th science unit, and another student which is present outside the class, then that student can talk with the students, means they can transfer a sound energy from one point to another point. Understood? Means like that, our thermodynamic system consists of a ideal gas molecules, and they can transfer. Means this is the collection of group or objects, and that form a unit, and that unit may have a ability to transfer a thermal energy with the object which is present outside, and that is nothing but surrounding. Understood? And means this is a system. This class is a system, and a student which is present outside the classroom, that is the surrounding, or it is also called as environment. Means this is surrounding or environment. And a boundary separates, this is the boundary. A boundary separates the system and surrounding. Understood? Means, I repeat, what is the definition of thermodynamic system? Thermodynamic system is a group or collection of objects, and that may have a ability to exchange the thermal energy with the surrounding. Anything which is not a part of system, means which is outside the system, that is called as surrounding, or it is also called as environment. And boundary separates the system and surrounding. Understood? Then the different types of the thermodynamic system. There are three types of thermodynamic system. First is an open system. This is an open system, and in that system two arrows are there. First is this arrow, and second is this arrow. This is heat, and this is matter. This is a system which freely exchange the heat and matter with the surrounding, and that system is called as open system. For example, suppose a water boiling in a pot. A water boiling in a pot, at that time what happened? We feel the heat, means that system can transfer the heat with the surrounding, and also the steam is flowing outside the surrounding. We know that the solid, liquid and gases, they are the states of matter, and the steam, that is nothing but matter. Means that steam can exchange the surrounding system to the surrounding, and therefore an open system is a system that freely allows the heat and matter with the surrounding, and that system is called as open system. And water boiling in a pot, that is the best example of an open system. Then second, a closed system. Second type, that is a closed system. A closed system. In this system, only heat can exchange in between system and surrounding. means a water, suppose this is a water boiler, and in that water boiler, water is boiling, means only heat can exchange with the surrounding. Matter means steam that cannot transfer from this system to surrounding, and therefore that system is called as a closed system, a system in which only heat can allow to exchange with the surrounding. That system is called as a closed system. Then third type, an isolated system. An isolated system. This is a isolated system. Means no air is present here. No heat, no matter. A system that does not allow the heat and matter with the surrounding, that system is called as an isolated system. And a thermos flask means that cannot exchange the heat and also steam or matter with the surrounding. And that thermos flask, that is the best example of an isolated system. Understood? And these are the three different types of thermodynamic system. Then thermodynamic process. Thermodynamic process, any system suppose this is a thermodynamic system. That thermodynamic system that are having five variables, that system can be described with the help of five variables: pressure, volume, temperature, mass and density. These are a macroscopic variables, because we can see that variables, we can measure that variable, and therefore these variables, they are called as the thermodynamic variables, thermodynamic parameters or state variable, because they describe the state of the system. And therefore the thermodynamic process, when we supply heat, at that time these variables, they get changed. Means initial state and final state, that gets changed, and that is called as a thermodynamic process. Means a thermodynamic process is a process in which these thermodynamic parameters or thermodynamic states of a system that goes on changing, that process is called as thermodynamic process. Okay, now we have to study when energy flows into the system, when energy flows from the system. Okay, this is the system and this is the surrounding or environment. Now when temperature TS, that is the temperature of system, and temperature TE, that is temperature of the surrounding or environment, when TS is less than TE, means if the system is having 20 degree Celsius temperature and environment is having 40 degree Celsius, means temperature of surrounding is less than the temperature of the environment. At that time what happened? In first video we studied that the heat always flows from higher temperature to lower temperature. Means the energy transfer from this environment to the surrounding, and therefore this heat is absorbed by the system, and therefore this Q, that is always greater than zero, or that is nothing but the positive. Understood? Means system energy flows, this is the first case, energy flows into the system. Okay, energy flows into the system. Now second case, energy flows from the system when temperature of the surrounding is less than, second case, temperature of surrounding is greater than the temperature of environment. Means the temperature of this system is 40 degree Celsius and temperature of environment or surrounding, that is 20 degree Celsius. Then what happens? direction of this arrow that exactly reverse. Means the heat flows from the system to environment, and therefore Q is less than zero, Q is negative, and we can say that energy flows from the system. Understood? And third case, when temperature of TS and temperature of environment is exactly same, then Q that is equal to zero, means no heat enters or leaves through the system. And in this manner, we can say that when TS is greater than, TS is less than T, at that time Q is positive, energy or heat is positive. When TS is less than TE, then greater than TE, then Q is the less than zero, that is nothing but negative. And when TS that is equal to TE, then Q that is equal to zero. Understood? If you like my video, then share it, subscribe it, and if you have any query, doubt, then comment on it. Okay, thank you.